Hi, my name's Jim. I'm the pastor here at Flatirons Community Church, and this is my story. When I was a freshman in high school, that's the first time I ever tried the whole party scene, and I found out that I really liked it, and I was pretty good at it, too. So I really got into drinking as much as I could, smoking as much as I could, and I think I committed every sin I can think of. I think I've invented a couple new ones, and when you're in the party scene, you don't really study a lot. So I was on all the probations my college offered at the time. I'm not proud of that at all. I look back but I made a mess of my life. If I could sum it up, it's just like I became this person that deep down inside, I knew that's not who I was, who I was meant to be. Yeah, so I'm in my sophomore year of college, and I'm on swim team for my college, and one night at swim practice, I literally bumped into this girl in my lane and walked her back to her dorm after practice and started talking, asked her out, and the more I get to know her, the come to find out she's a Christian, really loves God. And I really wasn't into that, but in order to be with Robin, I had to go to church, and so we started going to this campus ministry at East Tennessee State, and I did not want to be there, but I wanted to be with her. And I remember the morning that we walked all the way to the front, there weren't any seats, and we plopped down on the first row, the third seat over, and I sat down, and that's the morning that changed my life. The campus pastor there, he started telling a story out of a book I'd never heard of. It's called Voyage of the Dawn Treader by C.S. Lewis, and I didn't read any of that stuff, but I listened to it as he started telling about this boy named Eustace, who, when he first started describing him, I thought, that's a cool little kid, you know, kind of a troublemaker, kind of a rebel, and I was like, I like him. And he was always arguing with somebody, kind of hard-headed, trying to get his own way. C.S. Lewis later says, when you start thinking dragon thoughts and acting like a dragon, then eventually you become one, and that's what happened to him. As Eustace said, you know, after a while, being a dragon's really lonely and isolating, and the relationships, and you just can't have what you used to have. And eventually, you don't want to be a dragon anymore. But how do you stop? As Eustace is there, and he's trying to clean up his life, fix his life, pull all that dragon mess off of his life, you know, eventually he just kind of throws up his arms and says, I can't do this. I can't fix my life. And I think that's that aha moment, that clicking moment in Eustace's head where he realizes that you can't fix yourself. You can't undragon yourself. The only person that can do that is Aslan. You know, I'm sitting there on that front row. This college student has blown up everything in his life, knows all the right answers, but I also know that I've messed up my life. And I hear this story about this little kid who turned into a dragon and then the lion undragging him. I'm sitting on the front row and I can't breathe. I'm like, this is my story. I'm having a conversation with God saying, this is it. I'm a dragon and I don't know how to fix me. I don't know what to do. All I know is I don't want to live like this anymore. So please help me. And that's when it started clicking with me about grace and forgiveness and about redemption and about being cleansed and letting God do for you what only He can do that you can't do for yourself. And I mean, He can't undo what I've done in my past. But he can reach into my mess and he can say, I found you in there. And he undragged my life. He started changing my life and healing up my life and kind of turning me back into that person that I was always meant to be. You know, I remember after Eustace is a boy again and he's been undragged, he's having a conversation with his friends and they ask him, so did it hurt? And I love his response. He said, yeah. It hurt, but it was a good hurt. Let me say one simple truth. If you're listening to this story and you're thinking to yourself, I don't know how to undrag my life. I don't know how to fix my life. Here's the truth. There is one person that can undrag in your life, and that's Jesus. You know, God used this story, Voyage of the Dawn Treader, to change my life. Maybe he's going to use it to change yours. Where I live, kind of the culture is people use tattoos to tell their story, and I always wanted a tattoo but could never find out the right one. I didn't want just some decoration or something like that. I wanted it to have meaning. And that's why I came up with this, because this is my story, a dragon being undragoned. So if you're wondering, did it hurt? Yeah, it hurt, but it was a good hurt, and it was worth it.